नमस्कार एंड वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल लर्न एचटीएमएल विद नंदू जाधव. इन प्रीवियस वीडियो वी सी द सीएसएस पार्ट वन एंड इन दैट पार्ट वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस द सिंटैक्स ऑफ सीएसएस एज वेल एज टाइप्स ऑफ सीएसएस एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस सिलेक्टर्स इन सीएसएस एज वेल एज पोजिशनिंग द एलिमेंट्स एंड इट्स फ्लोट एंड डिस्प्ले प्रॉपर्टीज of the CSS. So let us start with selectors. So CSS selectors. What is the selectors? Actually, the selectors or the CSS selector is the first part of the CSS rule. And these CSS selectors are used to select the content with proper style as per our requirement. Okay. There are a wide variety of CSS selectors, and the major CSS selectors that are commonly used are first one, that is the class selector, second one, that is the ID selector, and third one is universal selector. So first we will discuss the class selector. Okay, so class selector, this class selector is not a unique, that means you can apply this class selectors to multiple elements of single web page or multiple elements of your whole website. So we can say that this class selector is not a unique. Okay, this class selector is declared within the head section by using the style tag, and while declaring this class selector we need to use dot as a prefix with your class selector keyword. Okay, the keyword that is used for the class selectors may be any HTML tag keyword, that is without angle brackets, or you can use any other character or any other word or any other name to the class selector. Okay, so we will see with the example, that is the class selector. See the example. Here, this is the output of class selector example, and some text here are displayed with some styles. We will see first its source code. See here, this class selector is declared within the head section. See here, this is the head section, and this within the head section, the class selector is defined by using the style tag or within the style tag. Here two class selectors are used as per its rule. The class selectors are prefixed with a dot. See here, here is dot. Second thing, we can use any keyword, that means we can use any HTML tag keyword without angle brackets. See here, this is the I tag, but you know the NHJ is not a tag. So you can use any characters here for the class selector. Okay, then all the properties for this class selectors are same as like we discussed the types in internal CSS as well as in external CSS. We can use multiple styles that you want to apply to your element. So here the first one is the font size is set as a 20 pixels. Color is set as the yellow, that the 4 color, and letter spacing is here given, that the 20 pixel. Also background color is set as a black to the NHJ class selector, and to the I selector, to the I class selector, the background color is set as a red and text color is set as a white. Here in the body, these class selector, defined class selectors are called here with any HTML tag. See here in this example, after the heading the p tag is used, and with this p tag the class selector nhj is used, and to the nhj class selector the letter spacing is 20, background color is black, text color is yellow, and font size is set as a 20 pixel, and this is applied to this paragraph displays with class selector style. Okay, see once more here. See here, this is the first selector. Okay, letter spacing, background color, font color. These are we implemented to the first paragraph. If you see the second paragraph here, this to the second paragraph here also, the NHJ class selector, that is the is applied to this class, as well as the selector word is displayed with the I class selector. That means the selector word is displayed with the background color red and text color white. See here. Okay, so this is the selector, that the class selector, and we can use this class selector anywhere multiple time within the our web page or within our website. That means this class selector is not a unique. Okay, then we will see the next selector, that is the ID selector. This ID selector is a unique. Unique means you can apply this selector to single element of each web page or website only. That means we will use this to identify the uniqueness of the web page or of our website. At that time you can apply this style to our HTML element. Okay, as like class selectors, here also we can define this ID selector within this style tag, and within this style tag, or this style tag is placed within the head section of the HTML document. Okay, here there is a little difference in between class selector and ID selector is that the class selector is defined with a prefix dot, but here the ID selector is prefixed with the hash character. Remember, as like class selector, you can also use any HTML tag or any character or any word as a name to the ID selector. But remember, while using any HTML tag keyword, that there is no any angle bracket is used. If you see the example of ID selector, see here the example of ID selector. This is the output or example for the ID selector. We will discuss first. We will see here the source code of this one. See here within the head. See here within the head, the style tag is placed, and within the style tag, the ID selector is placed. This ID selector, as per its rule, is prefixed with a hash. Okay, and here you can use any name, any keyword, or you can also use any HTML tag. As like other syntax of CSS, we can place CSS properties within the opening and closing curly brackets. In this example, we use color, word spacing is used here, and background color is used here. So color is set as a yellow, that the font color is set as a yellow. Word spacing, that the spacing between two words, is given 150 pixels. Remember, pixels. And background color is set as a black. Okay, here is only a single style ID selector is defined. After declaring this style within the head, this ID selector is called to apply this style to the contents of the web page. Okay, here within the body or the body part, this NHJ ID selector style is applied to the heading level only. See here, heading level only. So this is applied to the H1 tag called ID equal to NHJ. There is no need to use here hash. Okay, just only call the name or keyword that you define. Okay, so ID selector example, this word or this sentence is displayed with the color, that the font color yellow, and there is a word spacing, that means spacing between ID and selector, spacing between selector and example, there is a 150 pixel spacing, and the background color for this ID selector example sentence is a black. Okay, so we will see here, there is a ID is in a yellow color text, all contents, and there is spacing between two words, that is the word spacing is a 150 pixels, and this one is the unique one. So there is this style is not applied to any other element of the web page. You can apply this method to only one time for each web page. So remember that this ID selector is a unique. Okay, so next one, the third one is Also, we can use class and ID selector both at a glance. We'll see example here. Here, both ID selector as well as class selectors are used. We will see its source code. We'll definitely know. See here, the dot and edge, that is the class selector. Dot means class selector, and hash I, that means the ID selector, is defined within the head section within the style tag. Okay, and this style, that the class NHJ and ID I, is called here within the body. Here the H1 ID equal to I, that is the ID selector example, is displayed with the style I, that is the ID selector, that is the background color red and color equal to white. And the remaining part, that the first paragraph of this page, is displayed with the selector style class. So the color is displayed as orange, letter spacing is given here as 20, and background color is set as a black. So this one is the example. This one is the orange color, background color black, and letter spacing. And here this is the ID selector, is a unique one, and this is not a unique. So we can use it multiple time. Remember, the class selectors are not unique. You can use, or you can apply this to multiple elements of a single web page. But remember, the ID selector is unique, so it is required to set to a single element of the web page. Okay, then our next one is the universal selector. This universal selector is used as a wildcard characters. Okay, in computer language, there are two wildcard characters. Especially here, only one wildcard character is used. That the two wildcard characters are asterisk, that the star, and a question mark. Here, while declaring style using this selector, universal selector, HTML provides this star, that the asterisk character. Okay, second thing, that it selects all the elements of the web page. It automatically applied to whole elements of the whole contents of the web page, remember. And this style is also declared within the head, within the style tag. Okay, if you see this example here, see here example 1, 2, 3, 4, there are four paragraphs are used. The first, second, and last line is displayed with color red. The second one is bold, and third paragraph is displayed in a blue color. Why? We will see its source code. You will notice that. See here, within the head, this style is used, and within that style, this universal selector is used. And universal selector is presented here, declared here, by using this asterisk, that is the star. Here the style is given to this contents is a color equal to red, font size equal to 20 pixel. And here in the second one, that is the ID selector is used, and ID selector, that is the para 1. Okay, and color is set as a blue. So when you call this ID para 1 selector, this text will be displayed in a blue. So all within that four paragraphs, or within that four lines, only this line is displayed as a blue. But here there is no need to call this star like ID selector or class selector. It automatically apply to whole web contents with this style. So this one, that the this CSS stuff up to this one, as well as this one, that the heading level 2 contents, and also to second paragraph, this all text will be displayed within the red color and font size 20 pixel. Here also remember, this h2 is given, so here the text is displayed as a bold, and the heading levels are always displayed bold. So font size is given 20, and this text displayed bold because these are placed within the heading level, but all the remaining parts are displayed with the declared style, that is the font size 20 and color red. Only the third paragraph, that this one, is displayed in blue because here the ID selector is used, and ID selector style is that the font color is displayed in a blue, so it displays the blue color. So this one is the universal selector. Clear? Then we will see the grouping the selectors. Grouping selectors is used to select all search elements which have same styles, which have same style definitions. Okay, and such kinds of elements or such kinds of styles are merged together, which automatically minimize the our HTML code. Okay, to separate these selectors, to separate these keywords, commas are used while grouping the elements or while grouping the selectors. If we see the example here, this one is the first example, that is the without grouping the selectors, the code, and with grouping the code. First way we will see the without grouping. This is the output for the without grouping. Here forms in HTML, form tag attributes, these all contents are displayed here with a specific style. First we will see its source code, then we will understand. See here, within the header U, H1, H2 and B, these are the selectors used, and the properties for each, that the U1, H1, H2, B, these all are the same. See here, font family is Tahoma, color equal to green. U, display the contents with underline effect. H1 with heading lower, heading level 1, that the font size is automatically larger than the all contents here. H2 is smaller than this H1, but the font color and font family is all selectors is Tahoma and green. Here H1 forms in HTML is displayed in H1, that means H1 is the largest one, so display, but it displays in a green color. Okay, same here, as per our requirement you use define U, then H2 as well as B. Here is H2 form tag attributes. Okay, here all the input controls list is displayed with B, and the last one, that is the reset button, is displayed without B, but I used here U tag. Okay, so it display with underline effect. This all 1 to 6 input controls name is displayed in a bold, but in Tahoma font as well as in a green color. Heading level 1 is also in forms in HTML is in family Tahoma and color green, and H2 is also input controls displayed in the, see here, form tag attributes. See, forms in HTML, these all are the displayed with the font Tahoma and color green, and all these text will be displayed here up to in bold. Only this U button is displayed with the underline effect, because U selector is used and U is a tag, is applied underline effect, so it display this one. If you see its source code one more time, then we need to define 1, 2, 3, 4, that is 4 lines to apply this effect. If you see, after grouping, the code will be, contents are same, effects are same, but when you see, when you compare this code, see here, only U, H1, H2 and B, these all tags are grouped together, and while grouping you need to separate these selectors by giving the comma only. Other file format, other font effect or other styles is same, that the font family is Tahoma and color equal to green. So we not need to display or declare the style on a separate line. We can group this element. So this one is the important one, and it reduces our time also, and it reduces our workspace of our hard disk also. Okay, so this one is the grouping the selectors. Okay, then positioning in CSS. CSS helps us to position our HTML element anywhere as per our requirement. If you see the syntax of positioning, see the selector, that here selector name is given, then position and their values given here, and we can position our any element or any block or any text with the appropriate value by using its top, left, bottom or right properties. Okay, if you see the positioning, this one, first one, the position, the values for these positions are: first one, that is the static; second one, that is the fixed; third one, that is the absolute; next one, that is the relative; and another one that is not in 12th syllabus, that is sticky. We will see what is sticky, what is static. One by one, sequentially, we will discuss all the functions of static, fixed, absolute, relative, as well as sticky. So first one, that is the static. This static is the default position in HTML. When you not set the position, it is the static. Remember, this one is static, and it is not affected by this top, bottom, left, right properties. Okay, this is the default one. If you see the first one, another one, that is the second one, that is the fixed. This property helps to put the text field on the text fixed on the browser. That means when we apply this position, then the applied element is fixed on the web browser, and this fixed property forces an element into fixed position relative to the browser window. The fixed element will not move even when the page is scrolled. We will see with examples here. Example of fixed positioning. See here, this is the paragraph 1. It started from the top left corner. There is no space here. 1, 2, 3, 4. These are the paragraph. Actually, these are the text. And here, one image is displayed. As well as at the right side, there is also this is the fixed position text. Remember, we will see first its source code. See here, style is given, that the P, first one, that the class selector is used here. Two class selectors are used. First one is the P, second one is the H1. Position for this one is also fixed, for the second one is also fixed. The actual value, that the top, right and color, is given using number of pixels. Okay, position for the heading one is fixed, and top 100, from top at the 100 pixel, from left, that is the 150 pixel. And these class selectors are called, or this style is called or applied to some elements. Here within the body, see, there is a image. Okay, image is inserted, img, with class equal to h1. That means here H1 class is used to the image, and while declaring or defining this heading level 1 H1, the position is fixed, given as fixed, and the actual position is given at from the top 100 and from the left, that the 150 pixels. Okay, so this image will be displayed from top 100 pixels, from top 100 pixel, and from left, there is a 150 pixel. After that, there are all text. But when you see the output, then this P or this all contents will be automatically start here from the first character. Here also another one, that the class P. This is the fixed position text, and fixed position text, the value is given from that the from top 150. See here, from the top, that the 400 pixel, and from the right, there is a 50 pixel, and this style, this positioning is applied to this paragraph. This is the fixed position text, or the fixed position text. Okay, so it displays here. This is the fixed position text. Remember, from top, that the remember, and from 400 pixel, and from right, that is the 150 pixel. But when you see this image, it displays 100 and 150 pixels as per our values, and the surrounding text will be automatically takes the remaining space here, or the surrounding text of that image. This is the fixed positioning. Okay, if you see another one, that the absolute. This property sets an element in a specific location, and it is not affected by the flow of the page. This property position the element at the specified coordinates relative to your screen top left corner. See first example here of the absolute. See here, when we will see here first the fixed. This is the fixed example. When we scroll the content, the image or this fixed contents is fixed. Okay, but when you set this position to the absolute value, then it move the text. This one is the fixed one, but here the position of this image is set as a absolute. Absolute at that position. That means when you scroll the content, it automatically scroll with all the content. So we can say that the absolute value, that the absolute positioning is given to the image. We will see its source code. See here. Here also you will see P and H1 is used. P, the position is fixed, is given to this paragraph, already we discussed. And here position equal to absolute, and this position equal to absolute is given, is called to this image. So from top and left, this one is the 150, and it automatically scroll with all the contents. So this one is the absolute positioning. Okay, so absolute positioning. Now the third one, that is the relative. The relative positioning property is used to set the element relative to its normal position. Okay, it's set to the normal position, and other content will not be adjusted to fit into any gap left by the element. See, we will see with example, you will understand. See here, this is the example. Here, this image is applied with the relative positioning. The value is given, or the position is given as like the this one, that the fixed one. See, this one is a fixed example. Positioning of this one and this one is the same. But when we discuss, or when we check the fix, the gap of this image will be automatically filled here in the fixed positioning. But when we discuss, when we check the relative value, then the gap cannot be filled by any text. That is the importance of this relative positioning. And this text is, or this image will be automatically scrolled with these contents. Okay, so this is the fixed position, this one fixed one, and this one is the relative positioning. Once more, we'll see the source code here. See here, its source code, position fixed for this paragraph, and for this heading level 1, that is called to, for the image, is position is relative, and the value is set of this position is from top 100 and from left, that is the 150 pixels. Clear? So this image is relatively positioned with the space, or with the position top 100 and left 150. So it displays like this one, and this space cannot be filled by any text in while we position the text as a relative. Okay, so next one we will see, actually we will see the sticky. This sticky is a combination or hybridization of relative and fixed positioning. This sticky is not actually in our syllabus, I think, in 12th syllabus, but actually sticky is also important value, and it is a combination, it is a hybridization of relative and fixed position. Okay, first we will see its source code, then we will discuss. See here, within this style, two class selectors are used here, that the P and H1. Here H1's position is set as a sticky, and here the value from the top is set as a 0, and value from left is also set as a 0. Still it is display at the after this text, this image will be displayed. So automatically it will be comes after that two paragraphs. Clear? Okay, now we will see the example. Now we will see its output. See here, the text is displayed first two lines, after that there is the image. This image is positioned as a sticky. This is the combination of relative and fixed positioning. Okay, when we scroll the contents, see here, then this image is stick at the given position. That means when you scroll the contents, it scroll up to the given position, that the from top 0 pixels and from left that the 0 pixel. So automatically it goes up to 0 pixel top, up to 0 pixel left, and then stick. So we can say this one is the sticky position. Okay, so this is the positioning in CSS. Now we will see the float properties are also important for us, that the float properties. The float property defines the flow of contents, how our elements are placed, how our elements can be displayed by, we can control this by using this float properties. Some types of the floating properties are, first one, that the float equal to none. This is default property and this shows the element as it is. Okay, for example, we will see the float equal to none. See, in this example, in this output, this image is displayed with the float equal to none. Okay, if we see its source code, we will see here style img float equal to none. In this example, the image will be default float to the none in the text, and the text in the paragraph will be displayed after that image. See here, the text is displayed after that image. Clear? After that image. That means image align equal to left, or just default alignment, we insert image imgsl.jpg. It displays like this one. Automatically, the remaining text or the text which are placed after that image will be automatically shift to the bottom. It's same as like this one, that the float equal to none. If you say the float equal to left, same process, same example, then automatically all the text up that are placed after that image will be automatically comes at the right side, because the float value is set as a left. So this image is set or this image property float is set as a left. See its example. See here, image float equal to left. So the image will be automatically shift to the left, and the text that are placed after that image will be automatically comes beside that image. Okay. Then third one, that is the float equal to right. Same process, float equal to right means image is shifted to the right, and after the text, after that the image, the text will be displayed beside this at the left side. This is the float right. Float initial sets this property to its default value. Default value, see here, default value, that means like this one. Okay, so float property initial is equal to float property none. Clear? And there is also another one, that the float inherits, that inherits this property from its parent element. Okay, then display properties. We will see the display properties. The display properties in CSS defines how the components, that the block level elements, divisions, that the hyperlinks, heading, these all are the block level tags, are placed on the web page. That means how we can define this component are set by using this display properties. It specifies how the element is displayed. As the name suggests, the property is used to define the display of different parts of a web page. Its values, first one, that the inline. It is used to display an element as an inline element. We will discuss all these details. Second one is block. It is used to display an element as an block element. It starts on a new line and takes up the whole width of the browser window. We will discuss with example here also. Third one, that the inline block. Actually, in our textbook, I think the value is given as a block hyphen inline, but that is wrong. Inline hyphen block is the actual value for this display property. This value is very similar to inline element, but the difference is that you can control the width and height of that block, okay, by using this inline block, that the combination of both inline and block. And last one, that the none. the element is completely removed. We will see here with example. See the example here. Here all the display properties code is given. The first one see here, display inline. It is used to display an element as an inline element. This one is the inline element applied text when the display property is set as inline. Okay, first we will see source code. See here, P color equal to red, font size equal to 25 is a one style, one declared style. Then second one, p.ex1, p that the paragraph one, as like the paragraph example one, ex1 that is the example one, and here the display property is set as a null. So display equal to none. What is the display equal to none? See, display equal to none means the element is completely removed. Okay, if we see one more time, first one we will see the display inline. Okay, display inline. Okay, so we will see with source code first. Okay, display equal to none, display equal to inline for example 2, display equal to block for example 3, and display equal to inline block for example 4. Now this style is called applied within the body. Here first one, the display property for the display equal to inline. Okay, inline property is used, h2 is given here. It is used to display an element. After that, there is a ex2, that the p ex2, that is the ex2 means display inline is applied, and this content display inline. All the contents, all the block elements are placed in that line, not displayed at the new line. So it display the contents here inline, and after that the text is continued. Okay, this is the inline. In display block, see here, in display block, in block, that is the for example number 3, it is used here. See example 3, where is example 3? See here, here is example 3. After the text, the p class equal to example 3, hello friends is given here, and here also paragraph is closed, here also paragraph is, that this style is closed, but the text is displayed at new line and it capture whole width of the browser window. That means after this element, the text will not be displayed at beside this block. It automatically shift to the new line. So this one is the display block property. Display inline block. See here, this value is very similar to the inline element, but the difference is that similar, why? Because it displays inline. This element is displayed inline, but there is a little difference that we can control the height and width. We can set the height and width. Okay, so we can see here that the inline block here, this value is very similar to inline element. Okay, and the value is set here as, here height equal to 155 pixels, width equal to 500 pixels. Okay, here also the value is given, but this value is does not affect. Width equal to 1500 pixel is not displayed in inline. Height 55 pixel is not displayed in, but here, but here the in inline block display property, the we can control the height and width. So it display the contents here. Height and width is set to the 500 pixels. See, 500 pixels. If we increase this one, see here, we will change the values here. See here, height is given 155 by default. Now check the default one, given one, and width is set as a 500 pixel. So it displays the contents like this one. If we set the, we can change the value. Instead of 155, suppose we set the height as a 355, and instead of this width 1500, if we set the value as a 1500, then we will check See here, we'll refresh this page. See, the height and width is displayed up to this one. Okay. If we control the width, width is set as 1500, so it goes up to 1500. Height is given as a 255 pixel, so height is given 255 or 355. If we change it to 155, and if we change it to 200, suppose, and then refresh this page. See here, 200 is the width and 150 or the given value is the height. We can set this one as per our requirement. This is the only difference between inline and inline block. Okay, last one, that is the display equal to none. If you check the code for the none, when you set the display property as a none, the element is completely removed. For example, p class equal to ex1. See here, ex1 is the display equal to none. Okay, and display equal to none, after that there is a hello friends. This hello friends element or block element is completely removed when the display property is set as a none. So it displays, see here, it, the element is completely removed. There is no hello friends or this block will be displayed. Clear? So this one is the display property of the CSS. I think we discuss all the selectors, float properties, as well as the display properties with example. I hope you like this, you enjoy all the contents. Basically, this CSS properties and all these selectors and all these floating properties will be understand you when you practically implement individually, one by one sequentially, then you will notice all the importance, all the features of each and every property and their values. So thank you students for watching my this video. Today we complete all the CSS important factors, important parts. I hope you all enjoy this one. So keep watching, keep learning, stay with me. Thank you.